All right, students, welcome back. We're back here at the Circle, and what I'm going to be doing today is I'm going to calculate circumference. And if you don't know what circumference was, circumference is just the distance around a circle divided by the distance across it. So what we're going to do is calculate that number. It's about 3.14. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to walk around this circle right here. As I walk around the circle, I'm just going to count my steps. And then when I count my steps, I'll write that down. That's my circumference. And then when I walk across the circle, I'll just count how many steps across. We'll do that down here. And then we'll calculate that up in the classroom. So let's begin. Let's start off by walking across. I'm going to start at this point right here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. About 92 and a quarter going around. And now I'm going to just go across and see how many steps it is for that. 1, 2, 3, 27, 28, 29, 29 and a half. All right, boys and girls, I went around and I went across. Now let's take it up to the classroom. All right, greetings, students. We're back in the classroom and we're going to see if pi can be calculated by dividing your circumference by your diameter. So circumference, once again, is going around the circle, that distance. Diameter is going across. And when I went around the circle, this doesn't really look like a good diameter, but we'll just stick with that. When I went around the circle, it was about 92 and one quarter steps. And as I went across the circle, I took 29 and one half steps, about. So to figure out pi, it's just the distance around divided by the distance across, or circumference divided by diameter. So I pick out my numbers here, 92.25. I divide that by 29.5. And I use my trusty calculator, which is somewhere around here. 92.25 divided by 29.5. That gives me about 3.127. You estimate that is about 3.13. Ooh, so I was a little bit off. So pi is actually 3.14159 and a whole bunch of numbers going on forever. But I get pretty close, so I'm quite happy with that. And as an added note, to figure out my percent of error, basically I want to see how far off I was. So actual pi is 3.14. My calculated pi, making me hungry, is 3.13. So if I subtract those two, so the difference is just subtracting that, the answer is obviously 0.01. I was off by 0.01. So my percent of error, 0.01, based on the actual pi, again, estimated 3.14, and just multiply it by 100%, that'll give you my percent of error. So if I do that, let's see, 0.01 divided by 3.14 equals, and then I multiply that by 100, I get a 0.318% of error. I'm pretty excited with what I did here. Last year, some of you guys did this. The sixth graders, you didn't do this, but so this is familiar to you guys. But if you want to for homework, go find some circles at your house, measure around it, measure across it. If you're allowed to go outside, find some circles out in a park or something that you can walk around and walk across. You can use sticks, you can use string to measure things around. I'm also going to give some assignments based on this, so I'll give you some circles and with some diameters, and so that way you can figure those things out.
and divide it out. And as extra credit, you can figure out your percent of error. I hope you enjoyed this video. There are a few more videos coming up and a few more videos that I've done in the past. So go ahead and click on one of those videos that are right over here. You could also click on one of my food videos. Please share this with as many people as you like that love math and love to eat. That helps with the YouTube algorithm that many people come in. And don't forget to thumbs up. Make sure you like that. That also helps with the algorithm. Share and have a great day.